Welcome to Cleves Tech and another video in our Fooocus for Stable Diffusion series of videos. In this video, I'm going to be discussing styles and how they work in Fooocus. And don't miss my other videos covering other aspects of Fooocus, from installation to poses and face swap. You've probably been using Fooocus now for a little bit. You're in the advanced section, you found the styles section, and you get a whole bunch of different styles in there, and you're not necessarily sure exactly what all these things do or how they work. That's what I'm going to try to explain today. It's actually pretty simple. All the styles are in Fooocus is they wrap around your regular prompt for the most part. All but the Fooocus V2, which I'll get to in a moment. They add certain styles or the keywords that you would normally use to get the results that you're looking for from these styles. So for example, a photograph one is going to add keywords for photograph. So instead of you having to type in all the details that you want to get, a masterpiece, all this sort of stuff, you just type in the actual content of what you're looking for, and Fooocus with these styles will take care of the rest. That's not always the case. You may have to tweak them yourself. And it is a good idea sometimes, I feel, to know what's being added to these so you have a better idea of what could be negatively affecting the results that you're trying to get from one style if you have another style enabled, because they will fight with each other if they're, you know, they contradict each other. So for this, I've just gone ahead and set it up. I'm running it at the speed setting with the standard model under the run.bat. And these are the normal ones that are checked off to begin with. I'm gonna start off with Fooocus V2 because that one adds, when you generate an image, and we're going to actually pull that up right now. So in the log file, if we go into here, this is the actual prompt that I typed in, and that's it. But you'll notice here, Fooocus V2 expansion, it adds more to that prompt. Now, that is actually going to be different on each one. It's not always going to be the same. This one and that one actually are different. That's why Fooocus V2 is different than the other ones, because it actually, it'll add different things to each prompt as it goes. So I'm not going to dive into how that works, but do understand that that's different from the other styles. So by unchecking that, we will now remove all that extra stuff it added from here to the end. Now, that's not all that's added is the key thing here. You only see, and hopefully they're going to add this in an upcoming update, but you don't see in the log these other styles and what gets added. So let's go for the Fooocus Sharp one. What that does is it takes the prompt that's been put in and then puts it inside of this area here, and then it's adding the rest of the information you see here into the prompt. So it basically combines multiple things into one prompt. The same thing with the negative. This one, not all the styles will add a negative, but this one does. So this will add those things to your negative prompt when you use that style. Now, the Fooocus Enhanced one is a little bit different. Fooocus Enhanced only adds a negative prompt. It doesn't add any of the regular prompt. This is all in the negative prompt that's going to be added in there when you use Fooocus Enhanced. And this is why I mentioned when you're testing things, you want to not use the styles a lot initially, because you don't know, especially with the Fooocus V2 expansion, you don't know what words are being added until after, if you go into the log. So that's why it's a good idea that when you're testing new models, new LoRAs, things like that, uncheck the styles. Use the styles once you know what the results are that you're getting without the styles. Those are your primary ones. So let's go ahead. I'm going to leave those checked for the moment, but I'm also going to be looking for, let's go with an adorable 3D character here. And all I'm going to do is just check off that one. I'm not going to uncheck the other ones. I just want to give you an idea of what's going to happen. Now, this is actually what's added to that prompt. Is the adorable 3D character, then your prompt, and then 3D render, adorable character, 3D art, and then you have the negative is added in there. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna actually generate the same thing that I've generated here. I'm actually gonna use the standard seed, and we're going to go ahead and generate. Okay, so we have our images generated, and I am going to bring up the photo amp so we can compare these images and see the difference. So looking at these, it's not a drastic difference between those two results. And honestly, it's definitely not the results I was looking for as far as the adorable 3D character. I got these swapped around, but. And the reason for that would be the fact that if we load this up, you'll see it actually added not only the expansion, which is sharp, focused, detailed, elegant, all the things that are probably not going to give us necessarily the results that we want. And then it added the other styles. Let's go back now, and I'm going to uncheck all of these styles here. We're going to use the same seed that we used before, and we're going to generate again. Okay, I think you can already tell the difference without me even having to open this up, but I'm going to do it anyways. This was the standard one we did. Then we added the adorable 3D character, and it really didn't change an awful lot. Then we get rid of all the other styles and just did the adorable 3D character, and you can see the huge difference because everything that was in these other ones is not added to this one. So it's only getting that adorable 3D character prompt. And in theory, we should be able to put the exact same thing in there and get the exact same results, or pretty close. Let's go ahead and find that out right now. We're gonna find the adorable 3D character, and I'm gonna actually go ahead and we are going to. So normally it would put it after, okay, so in here. Okay, so we have the exact same one. I'm gonna uncheck the style, but we also remember this one does have the negative prompt. So let me actually copy that one in here. So now we should get, in theory, the same results. Okay. Let's verify, but I think we can say with pretty good, I'd say those are exactly the same. So we end up with the same results on both of these. And the reason for that is exactly as I explained, when we do that, we're not getting any styles or anything. It's only adding the prompts we want in there. There's no other added stuff from Fooocus. That basically disables everything else when what I just did. So that style, the adorable 3D character, got the exact same results of me typing the whole thing in. But now you don't have to type all that stuff in. You only had to type in the actual thing that you wanted and not the rest of those instructions. So let's go ahead and try the adorable 3D character with just the Fooocus V2 expansion. And I have removed the other two just to see what we get for results out of this. So this was these were the two that were the adorable 3D character. One was the style, or the style. The other one was where we put in the prompt. And this one was the Fooocus V2 expansion, text expansion that was added. And it still gets a pretty decent results when it comes to the adorable 3D character, but it may not be exactly, I mean, it's not exactly what I would expect, but this gives you a really clear picture of exactly what's happening in the background and why you want to be unchecking and checking the things to make sure you're not fighting each other when you're using these styles, that they're not going against each other. You could actually even, there's other different ones in here. Oh, I will mention as well, a lot of people do ask, what is the SAE or SAI and the MRE? Those are just the ones that developed the styles. That's all that that means. And then you can mix and match, you know, your styles if you want to generate all new combinations. what you may get for results is, you know, hit or miss, because as I said, a lot of times these things could be fighting with each other, so it's going to be hard to tell. Sometimes it may even be useful to go in if you ever want to see what these styles are. If we go into the focus folder and then into the program folder, there's actually a folder in here called SDXL styles. And if we go into here and we can open these up with any, you know, a notepad is perfectly fine, whichever. And you can look in here to actually see what the styles are. So you could get a pretty good idea of how these are built, and you could actually pull ideas from the styles. There's actually several different styles in here, files. So if you're ever looking to see what those are, it's useful to explore that to find out what's going on. So we have our new generation, as you, as is visible here, we've added a new style to it. So these were our original one on the right, and then we had our the one with the expansion, and then this was the bad dream style. So you can mix and match those. There is an awful lot in here. I'll probably go over a lot of these at some point to compare what the results are. Okay, honestly, I think that pretty much covers all the basics of styles, of understanding how they work. Like I said, whenever you're testing anything, uncheck other styles. That way you make sure that they're not interfering with each other. If you found this video helpful, please do consider clicking the like button, because it does help. And questions or suggestions for video ideas, please leave a comment. I'm actually thinking about doing a weekly video of pulling things from comments. Thanks for watching, and don't forget, I do have other videos on Fooocus, and I'm going to have obviously more in the future. And have a great day.